Yo, what's good everybody? Thanks for tuning in and stopping by the channel. From everyone over here at Team MSTR, it's always really appreciated. Now for today's video, we will be introducing our brand new watch to the collection, the Voyager, as well as discussing the difference between an automatic and a quartz movement, and which one is probably best for you. Now before we do move forward and get into the details of this video, I'd like to take this time out to stop and welcome our new viewers. Please hit that subscribe button, that way you get alerted for all the new content that's headed your way. Turn on those post notifications and hit that like button, as it does go a long way for us YouTubers. Now to our returning viewers, as always it is greatly appreciated. Thank you for continuing to show the love. Now with all that said and out of the way, let's get right into the detailed review of our brand new watch, the Voyager, as well as breaking down the difference between the quartz and the automatic movement.
Now before we do start breaking down the details of the automatic versus the quartz, let's take a deeper look at the Voyager. The Voyager case size is a 42mm by 10mm thick, so that's a nice size watch on your wrist. The weight is an 8-ounce band. Okay, now the only difference in the Voyager between the automatic and the quartz is the colorways and of course the movement. Now first up, what you are seeing is the rose gold and the quartz movement. For me, I am a big fan of the quartz, though I do love an automatic watch, but for quartz it is a much easier wear only because automatic, you have to have it on your wrist in order for the kinetic energy to keep the movement going, which is keeping the time in place. With quartz, you simply push that crown in and just like that, you kind of set it and forget it. Now for this rose gold Voyager in full stainless steel, it is a quartz movement like we talked about. That movement is a Seiko 3-hand+8 Japanese quartz movement. It does feature a scratch resistant mineral crystal, and it has a really cool deployment buckle for the band as well. It is a 42mm by 10mm thick, so it's a nice size watch on your wrist. It's water resistant to 50 meters. It does feature a really cool turnstile bezel as well. Really deep luminescent index. Now if details are definitely your thing, the Voyager is something you need to really consider having in your watch collection. Especially this one in the rose gold, it's one of my favorites out of the colorways that we do offer for the Voyager series. So again, the difference between the automatic and the quartz, while the quartz is simply a movement that you push the crown in and the time keeps going, this comes down to convenient. The quartz movement is definitely offering that. You just simply push that crown in and the movement is going. Okay, diving into the automatic series of the Voyager. Now, I absolutely love this colorway too. I'm not a big fan of blue, but this one has definitely caught my attention. Now, I love the way the bezel is a two-tone from a nice deep metallic blue to a dark black. It features a turn on the bezel as well too, so that's a really cool feature, as well as that really nice bright vibrant luminescent index with the white index surrounding it. You have a beautiful sunray blue dial face that just really commands a lot of attention. I mean, this thing is truly eye-catching. You have the silver stainless steel case as well as band. Now this band also features a deployment buckle. Now again, the only difference between the Voyager series is the colorway and the movements, of course. Now the full automatic is water resistant to 100 meters and it does feature a sapphire crystal. So there are some upgrades to the automatic to the quartz. The movement chosen for the automatic Voyager is a Seiko NH35 Japanese automatic movement. Now the reason why I would ultimately stay with an automatic is because if you're into watches, you know that the automatic is somewhat of the Ferrari of the collection of watches. Because the movement is an upgraded experience. Now for me personally, I love the way the second hand sweeps. To me, it just creates a sense of class. It's something really cool to look at. But again, as I reframe, this is based off of my preference. Of course, I do have more quartz watch movements than I do have automatics, but I do prefer an automatic. As we're looking at these Voyagers, I think it's really important to ask yourself what type of watch that you're looking for as far as quartz or automatics. Now keep in mind, having a quartz, it is very easy to set and forget in a sense, while an automatic, you do have to be wearing the watch for that time to keep going unless you have a watch winder. But again, an automatic commands a different type of respect, a different type of feel on your wrist. While the quartz is a great watch nonetheless, an automatic is somewhat of a graduation to the higher class of watches, in my personal opinion.
Okay, now that wraps up the full breakdown of the difference between an automatic and a quartz movement featuring our new Voyager watch. Now because your thoughts do mean the world to us, we'd like to hear them in the comments section down below. Let us know what you thought about this video and what movement do you think is best for you, an automatic or a quartz? Me personally, I love an automatic. I love the way the hand just sweeps across with no tick. But again, just to reframe, this is my personal preference. Make sure you stay tuned for some detailed shots of this watch on wrist and some really cool lifestyles. Now again, I do want to ask that you hit that subscribe button. That way you get alerted for all the future content that's headed your way. Now that's going to wrap it up from everyone over here at Team MSTR. Thank you guys for always tuning in, continuing to show the love. Have a great day.